They treat me as if I'm some kind of crazy person, or like I have three horns coming out of my head. But what they don't understand is they're the ones that are crazy, and they're the ones that are so disconnected.
You make them scared. You make them victims, and you change their mindset. And then possibly you can pass anti-gun legislation. Is that what happened in Las Vegas?
The average leftist, I agree with you, actually does think you've got five heads or I've got six heads.
And now you guys use your COVID hoax to like set a checkpoint up so you can take over the parks and start charging? It's unconstitutional.
Her reservation is that we live in a free country. We live in America.
Also, let's bear in mind, maybe he doesn't have as much influence as he used to, because he's just like talking to people who don't even care that he's talking to them. Like, how diminished is Alex Jones? They're not interested.
I think they're really scared of the American people, because here's what they do know. They know that if the American people actually woke up from the dream that they're living in, the so-called American dream, where it's more like entertainment at like Roman games or something like that.
The left is scared of the American people, and that if only they would wake up, you know, like if they'd become woke or something like that. That's an interesting little slip up there. But also, we're scared of the American people. The Republican Party has won one popular vote in a presidential election in basically three decades now at this point. If anyone is afraid of the American people's effect writ large over our politics, it is gonna be you guys.
The look in her eyes, that intonation of, I'm smarter than you. And because of space lasers, and this crazy can, and it's because it's a show, and they say that on the forums. This is the best show I've ever seen. Cause dude, get Netflix, get Disney Plus, go watch some Disney movies. They've got some good shows on there. You don't need to bring that to the halls of Congress. And they talk about false flags all the time, but the only false flag operation going on is that she pretends she cares about the United States. She doesn't. She cares about being cool on QAnon conspiracy theory message boards. That's it. If she really cared, she'd do her research. She's a congresswoman. But it makes her feel so good and so important to feel like she's got that edge by asking questions. I love when they have rhetorical questions that actually have answers.
Everyone is wanting to make it as easy as possible and kind of appeal to the lowest common denominator of the easiest way to get as many people registered as possible. I see it the exact opposite. I want to make it hard. I want it to be something that people have to choose and re-choose and have to prove that they're a citizen and all that. So I would love, and again, I know this is controversial. Some people like it, some people hate it, you know, but I think we should clean the slate completely and have people have to re-register, say, every 8 years or maybe even every 12 years, a privilege to vote, you know, and I want you to have to actually like have to work to sign up, not have it be that there's this auto enroll and every single person is getting a ballot and all that. I don't like any of that.
I also don't like any of that, whatever that was. Unfortunately, that's Rachel Hamm, who is not just some rando. She is a rando, but she's a rando who's running for Secretary of State here in California, actually, wants to be my Secretary of State. And if what she says about voter registration and all of that doesn't scare you enough, wait until you find out why she decided to run. She said she ran as a Republican because she claims Jesus appeared in her closet and told her to do so. Hamm said she began her campaign because she, quote, would rather be dead than live in a communist country. How about neither? Like, does it have to be one of the two?
Are but you anyway, mispronouncing Jesus? Was it her friend Jesus, like a guy she knows?
Maybe named Jesus? There was a Jesus in the closet. I don't know. But yeah, she thinks it's because Jesus showed up and she doesn't want it to be easy to vote. But she also has some other thoughts about the voting process. Take a look at a little bit more of Rachel Hamm.
The education part of it is so important because we do want people who are actually looking into what they're voting on, the people that they're voting on, the legislation, you know, like they really need to be educated. And when we do the system that we're doing now, it causes people who are not educated on what's going on and they don't even maybe care, you know, enough to look into it. And then they're voting on things.
Wasn't it Trump that once yelled that he loved the poorly educated? Yeah. No. She's got the, like, you are not smart enough. All of you watching this, You're a bunch of big dumb donkeys. You're not qualified to vote. You need to listen to the Jesus Closet Woman. She's done the research on Jesus and closets and then integrated it as the best academia does.
If 30 to 40% could agree that this was legitimate tyranny and it needed to be thrown off, they need to have sufficient power without asking for extra permission. It should be right there and completely available to them in their living room in order to affect.
Okay, so that is Representative Thomas Massie, who seems to pop up once every month or so for some explicitly pro-gun, pro-political violence, weird fashy memes and stuff like that. He's saying there that if 30 to 40% of this country agree that there's a tyranny, we need to have them have the ability, without any extra planning or prep or purchasing, to overthrow the US government. So there cannot be any limits on any sort of military hardware that would make it so that one third of the country deciding they've had enough, that they can just go and murder the federal government. He is a sitting member of that government. And I have a feeling, I don't know, to some extent I'm speculating, I'm speaking for him, that this would not extend to 30% of leftists, Antifa people deciding that it's time to overthrow everything. This is just a sop to his base. They love the idea of eventually being able to gun down the National Guard, like murder Congress. Like every once in a while, this is how you build clout on the right now, is implying that that is acceptable and that trying to stop that from happening is somehow wrong.
They're already doing it. I mean, and these are the same people in the same breath who say blue lives matter. And yet you've got the Boogaloo boys who've absolutely been inspired by, you know, statements like this, who are killing cops, who are killing National Guard, who are killing service members. What the hell are we talking about anymore?